The purpose of the Science of Opioid Dependence Kit is to engage students in roles as researchers and doctors as they design a study to find genetic links to opioid dependence and suggest treatment strategies. By conducting agarose gel electrophoresis on pre-amplified PCR patient DNA samples, they explore how a mutation in a human dopamine receptor gene might influence opioid dependence. The Science of Opioid Dependence Kit contains a total of 5 activities. Activity 1 focuses on factors in opioid dependence. Students review information on the opioid crisis, reward pathways, and pain medication and raise ideas and questions about causes and solutions. Students review patient responses on an opioid risk tool, ORT, to assess risk of future opioid dependence and make a recommendation on prescribing opioids. Activity 2 involves students designing a human genetic research study. Students identify genetics as a potential factor in assessing risk of opioid dependence. Then design a human research study to determine whether SNPRS1800497 is associated with opioid dependence. Activity 3, conducting the research study. A local university is conducting your human genetic study and has recruited 127 individuals to participate. Your class will help the university team determine the participant genotypes, with each student group determining the genotype of a different set of samples. Your results will be combined with those of the university, and you will then analyze and interpret the full data set. 1. Sketch your agarose gel setup. Label each of the 8 wells with the sample that will be loaded. Lane 1 will be MWR, molecular weight ruler. Lane 2 will be CT, PCR-controlled DNA. Lanes 3 through 8 will be participant DNA samples. 2. Place a 1% TAE agarose gel into the electrophoresis chamber. Be sure that the gel is oriented so that the wells are closest to the black negative electrode, or cathode. 3. Fill the electrophoresis chamber with enough TAE buffer to cover the gel by about 2 millimeters. 4. Load 20 microliters of MWR in lane 1. 10 microliters of CT, control DNA, in lane 2, and 10 microliters of the DNA from assigned participants in lanes 3 through 8. 5. Place the lid on the electrophoresis chamber and connect the electrical leads to the power supply, red to red and black to black. 6. Turn on the power and run the gel. Ask your instructor for the run conditions. 7. When the electrophoresis is completed, turn off the power and remove the lid of the chamber. 8. Carefully remove the gel from the electrophoresis chamber and transfer it to a gel staining tray. Be careful, the gel is very slippery. 9. Stain and/or visualize your gel as directed by your instructor. 10. Check with your instructor for any further directions or information. Activity 4 has students collecting and collating experimental data and calculating allele and genotype frequencies. They then write an evidence-based scientific explanation. Activity 5 provides students with the opportunity to learn the concept of probability values, p-values, analyze published data about multiple genes, and reassess their claim. The activity closes with students discussing the broader questions of what should be done to address the opioid crisis.
Subscribe to the Bio-Rad Explorer channel and you'll discover enriching and fun biology and life science videos. Watch what you'll explore. Subscribe now.